In the annals of history, few civilizations can boast the profound ingenuity of the ancient Greeks. They laid the bedrock of modern mathematics, astonishingly calculated the Earth's circumference with remarkable precision, and delved into the very essence of matter with their discovery of the atom. From the piston pump to the pneumatic self-shooter, and even the steam engine, the Greeks' scientific and inventive prowess was nothing short of extraordinary. Yet, despite their groundbreaking achievements, centuries and in some cases, millennia would pass before these discoveries found widespread application. Unlike the Renaissance and Enlightenment, which ignited the flames of the scientific and industrial revolutions, one must ponder why the Greeks' brilliance did not herald a similar epoch. Why did the Industrial Revolution not dawn at the beginning of our era? In the Archaic Period, the Greeks were not insular in their quest for knowledge. They eagerly assimilated innovations from foreign lands. From Asia Minor, they acquired the art of ironworking and the minting of coins. Phoenicia gifted them the alphabet and decked ships. Egypt imparted the secrets of geometric measurement, glassmaking, and water clocks. It is no coincidence that the western regions of Asia Minor, home to Greek settlements, became the crucible for the burgeoning of Greek culture and natura and natura philosophy. Legends tell of Thales and Pythagoras journeying to Egypt, seeking wisdom from its ancient repositories. By the second half of the first millennium BC, Greek scientists and inventors had outstripped their Eastern counterparts. Philosophers like Leucippus and Democritus introduced the atomistic universe concept, envisioning a cosmos comprised of atoms navigating a void. Their theories, free from the constraints of religious dogma, underscored the significance of dynamics, paving the way for engineering advances. This evolution was vividly reflected in Greek construction and architecture. At the dawn of the first millennium BC, wood and adobe were predominant. Yet by its midpoint, the Greeks had embraced fired clay tiles and durable stone. They employed cranes and winches, revolutionizing construction with their ability to erect grand temples, expansive walls and intricate water systems, fountains and baths. A fascinating instance is that of Dionysus, tyrant of Syracuse. Amidst prolonged conflict with mighty Carthage, he summoned the era's greatest minds, including the young philosopher Plato. Under his aegis, formidable stone fortifications arose around Syracuse, and he pioneered the fearsome catapult, a symbol of military innovation and strategic vision. Around 387 BC, Plato, that master of dialectic, established near Athens his academy, a veritable cradle of Western thought, a precursor to our modern universities. Imagine the bustling intellectual marketplace. Philosophy, mathematics, astronomy, all under one roof. Mathematics, particularly, held a revered position, as evidenced by the academy's rather exclusive motto, "Let no one ignorant of geometry enter here." And let's not forget the women among Plato's students, a testament to the academy's surprisingly progressive spirit. His star pupil, Aristotle, that titan of logic and empirical observation, would later found his own Lyceum, a school renowned for its impressive library, a true repository of knowledge. This intellectual powerhouse thrived until the Roman conquest of 86 BC, a rather unfortunate end to a remarkable chapter. Following Alexander's conquests, Greek culture, like a wildfire, spread across vast swathes of land, from Europe to India. Syracuse and Athens were not alone. Alexandria, Antioch, Pergamon all became vibrant hubs of learning and scientific inquiry. The Ptolemies, those shrewd rulers of Egypt, understood the power of knowledge and consciously supported science and education. In the 3rd century BC, Ptolemy I founded the Magian, an institution that attracted luminaries from across the Hellenistic world. Its crowning jewel was the Library of Alexandria, a treasure trove of literary and scientific works. The library was primarily reserved for scholars, but a lesser-known library, housed in the neighboring Temple of the Serapeum, was open to the public. The physicians Herophilos and Erasistratus established an experimental medical school in Alexandria, celebrated for its pioneering work in dissection and the study of the nervous and circulatory systems. Euclid's seminal work, Elements, became the most revered ancient textbook on geometry and number theory. Apollonius made significant discoveries in conic sections, while Eratosthenes, the head of the Alexandrian Library, accurately calculated the Earth's radius, with an error of only 42 miles. The practical applications of Alexandrian scientists' work are evident in the field of mechanics, where they crafted intricate devices, such as automatic dolls and mechanisms for tracking celestial bodies. In 1901, one such mechanism was salvaged from a shipwreck near the Greek island of Antikythera. In 2016, a group of scientists published a research report on this sophisticated device and stunned the public. Historians, however, were aware of even more complex mechanisms predating this find. Hero of Alexandria, a true polymath of the first century AD, described inventions like the pantograph, the aeolipile, a steam engine, a vending machine, and a windmill truly ahead of his time. And then there's Archimedes, the legendary Syracusan, who, despite studying in Alexandria, made his own indelible mark on history. While his hydrostatics and screw are well known, his contributions to complex mechanisms rival those of the Antikythera. Now, the burning question, why didn't these innovations spark an industrial revolution centuries earlier? The standard explanation points to the reliance on slavery, which, while providing cheap labor, discouraged investment in expensive technology. Additionally, limited market size, lack of capital, and political instability following the Roman conquest may have hindered the widespread adoption of technical innovations. However, this explanation is overly simplistic. In the first half of the 19th century, some North American states also had a slave economy, yet they managed to develop industrial enterprises before slavery's abolition. The Hellenistic world's market size and capital may not have been as limited as modern historians assume. The Roman conquest was undoubtedly traumatic for ancient Greek culture, but the Romans soon learned from the Greeks and admired their genius. After the Roman conquest, Syracuse, Archimedes' city, ceased to be a major scientific center, but Alexandria continued to thrive, attracting scientists under Roman patronage. Rome became the epicenter of intellectual life, where scholars from across the empire, including Greeks, converged. Perhaps the primary reason for the absence of an economic and social revolution was the Mediterranean's limited resources. For instance, the aeolipile invented in Alexandria could have become a steam engine for Nile River ships, making grain transportation cheaper. However, steam engines required abundant, energy-intensive fuel, which was lacking in ancient Egypt. In 18th-century England, coal powered steam engines, but in Egypt, there was no affordable coal or wood. Human ingenuity, sans fuel, was insufficient to transform society. Centuries passed before the ancient Greeks' inventions, often rediscovered, found practical applications in industry and daily life. Yet, the wisdom of the ancient Greeks remains awe-inspiring. They thought, they debated, they dreamed, laying the foundations for future wonders. Their legacy endures, a testament to the enduring power of human intellect.
If you enjoy our short informative video, put your like and subscribe. Do not miss our upcoming videos. We may be a bit awkward, but we always manage to have a good time and find joy in the little things.